As soon as we arrived in England, we started playing cricket. The 6 weeks we didn't go to school, we were playing cricket in the street, milk a crate at the back as a wickets, and just I don't know how we found a ball and bat, and we were playing cricket all the time. We were a bit serious. We thought we could go one step further, because when we were playing cricket in school, we had PE teacher, very nice gentleman. He really helped us and show us how to play cricket. He was telling us technical things which we didn't understand. We just thought, you know, it's simple. It's my turn to bat now. I can swing anywhere I like and the ball the way I like it, you know. But once they start giving wide balls, then we realized, oh no, you have to be a bit careful. He helped us to get the basic things right. Once we got these basic things right, we were thinking we were improving all the time, every match we play, every single day, every week. Then there were some leagues player there. There were four teams, you know, they made a league there. And there was a team in league called Hydri. We played twice with them. First match, we've been told that we didn't take seriously, right? Because we were thinking we didn't bowl fast. We didn't do this, we didn't do that. So that's the only reason you won. Okay, boys. So what we'll do now, come back next week here, same ground, same time. We'll be here waiting for you. And when they came next week, we won again. And they were really disappointed. And when we won that match, we had a little meeting between ourselves after the match when they are gone. We were still sitting there with a packet of crisps and Coke. And we thought, if they are playing in leagues, how come we are not playing in leagues? So we were trying to get the opportunity to get into the league. We have our own team we called Kashmir. So then within the next 2 years, we were in league. We were playing for the fun, first thing. And it was a way to gather all the people. If we are not playing cricket, then we wouldn't have got all these people from Mirpur get together. And how are we going to see them? I can't go 15 people's home. So it's best 15 come in one place. Even sometime, you know, even it's raining, we knew it, we can't play cricket today, but we still get together. I remember very clearly Mr. Javed, who used to work in Habib Bank down in Dewsbury. He decided that he wants to make a league. He did. He got together with friends and for a year or so, at least, there were four teams. Then more team joined. We joined at least 2-3 years later on, when there were 8 teams, I believe. And then the team from Bradford joined. We remember West Bowling, and there were a few other teams also from Bradford. And from Huddersfield, 3-4 teams joined from there, Shabab and etc. Then later on, there was another team joined from Leeds called Khalsa. Sikh lads, they joined also. Then once Shabab joined, Mr. Tanveer, he was the selected chairman. And we used to go, I was secretary, we used to go for meeting in Leeds, Al Shabab restaurant, very close to bus station Leeds. And then I think it's Mr. Tanveer's idea. Then what he's done, he improved the league. He said the league will improve, the standard of the league and standard of the player will improve if we have some professional players. So unfortunately, we were young lads team, you know, all school boys. Half of the team was still going school, and probably 4 or 5 of us, you know, left the school. We were 17 years old, 16, 17, 18 years old, left the school. And there's no way we could afford the professional player. We couldn't afford our gear even, you know, we couldn't buy new bats. We were getting second-hand bats because when they had a professional player, they were winning most of the matches. But before that, we were winning them. We beat Shabab many, many times. We did not want the professional players. You know, but it's not only because we cannot afford it. We thought the game is for enjoyable and enjoyment and is for the local players only. So facing professional, we were playing a league here and people playing, for example, for Pakistan, people playing in India, right? If they are batsmen, then we are safe. We have absolutely no worries. But when they were bowler and they're bowling at tail-enders, number 9, 10, 11, right? We were just thinking we can make 5-10 runs, right? That's all we can do. right? And those people were really steaming and they really running like a test match is going on and it's going to rain in 5-10 minutes time and they need this wicket in this over, right? That's how they used to bowl. We did not have helmet there, it came afterwards. And I think that attitude was wrong, you know, because we were, you know, working class people and we need to go back on work Monday next day. We used to call Kashmir. Then once we got in the league, we were called Pakistan B because the Pakistan A and B cricket club, there were two teams. Then they decided that they can't run both teams. Sometimes they were short of players. Then they decided that we are going to finish one team. So they told me, then I said, okay, we'll take over. We are looking for the ground, you know, and they were also trying to help each other, people in Dewsbury. So if there are more teams in Dewsbury in the Quaid-e Azam League, that means the control is with the Dewsbury people.